Greetings from Test Prep Card. This is Manish over here. We receive thousands of calls, mails on weekly basis. And in that, there is a common question that we are going to address today through this piece of informative video, right? It is especially for those students who are preparing for JEE and JEE Advanced, whether India or abroad, I mean to say Middle East, US, Southeast Asia, wherever you are. The question is, what basically the fee that I have to pay for NITs and IITs, okay? I mean to say, I would like to put in this, please hear me very carefully so that you don't get confused in future. Currently, there are 76 centrally funded institutions in India, which are comprising of 23 IITs, then 30 NITs, 11 IITs, and then there are other centrally funded institutions approved by MHRD, Government of India. So here what basically happens that we divide this into two parts, IITs and NITs. So we will call here in this piece of video, for the sake of giving you the information in a very simple way, IITs. Okay. Now let's focus on what basically the fee that you have to pay for a ward for IITs, which is 23 number, is scattered in different part of India, old and new IITs, Indian Institute of Technology, which is prestigious all over the world. Correct. The fee that you have to pay for a ward for IITs is 1,10,000 approximately in almost all the IITs. Okay, 1,10,000 to 1,19,000. Or say the scale is 1,06,000 to 1,19,000 in IITs in India, and this fee is per semester. It means for 1 year you pay approximately 2,25,000, and for 4 year for a degree of BTech or B you pay 9 lakh. So the answer is for a 4 year degree of BTech or B from any of the IITs on an average you have to pay 9 lakh rupees. Okay. Now let's come to those centrally funded institutions which are not IITs, I mean to say NITs and IITs. For NITs and IITs, the fee that you have to pay on an average is that starts from 60 to 65,000, right? 60 to 65,000 Indian rupees per semester, okay? So you can say that it's 1,25,000 on an average per year. Approximately 5 lakh, varying on a scale of 5 lakh to 5.50 lakh for a 4 year degree of BTech or B from NITs, IITs and other centrally funded institutions in India. Is it clear to you? Now, if in NITs or IITs, you also want to avail for hostel, in hostel, the yearly fee is only 10,000 rupees. Yeah, you heard me correct. It's only 10,000 rupees yearly. Okay. So it's really something which everyone can afford, right? Very easily. Now there is one more thing, you know, the people who are living in the Middle East or all over the world. For that, there is quota. For Middle East, the quota is CIWG and DASA. And for rest of the world, I mean to say, if you don't belong to India and Middle East, you can go for DASA quota only. You cannot avail CIWG quota. CIWG quota is only for GCC countries. That's it. Now, under CIWG, the fee for a 4 year degree of BTech or B into these centrally funded institutions, which are mainly NITs and IIIT, is 5.50 lakh. Okay. Or currently in US dollar, okay, for a 4 year degree of BTech or BE, it is along the registration fee, which is $300. So for a 4 year degree of BTech or BE under CIWG quota in NITs and IITs, okay, it is how much? $8,300. Whereas under DASA, it is $32,000. If you are not living in the Middle East, if you are not living in India, if you are in any other part of the world, okay, the fee under DASA quota is 22 lakh Indian rupees for a 4 year degree of BTech or B or $32,000. If you belong to SAARC country, the fee would be approximately same. Okay. I mean, SAARC country, non-Indian students, right? So I think after hearing this, Your doubts regarding the fee is completely clear. I would also request you, if you have any queries, please do write in the comment section. We would definitely get back to you. Okay. You shall also click on the description below in order to have other information about your queries. Thanks a lot.